Hey everybody, my name is Kalle Slaap. I'm a watchmaker here in the Netherlands. And today I would like to tell you a bit more about lift angle. And I'm going to show you a really cool and cheap trick to determine the lift angle if you're not sure what a lift angle is. Lift angle, in a very short description, maybe too short, but it's a huge amount of theory behind it, is when the balance is moving, the amount of degrees that the balance is touching the escapement is lift angle. You can forget it directly. Important is lift angle for several movements can be different. In the range between 39 is incredibly low and 56, 7, 8 is really high. Usual standard for timing machines is a lift angle of 52 degrees. But especially with vintage watches, sometimes you have to change the lift angle setting in your time graph to get the right reading for amplitude. Sounds a bit abstract. I'm going to show you, it will make sense. So I'm going to show you the time grapher at the moment and see what are we looking at. Well, here we have a time grapher with the rate, the amount of seconds a day it's slow or fast. Beat error, you've probably seen our video on beat error and on timing machines. Please check it if you're into that in our YouTube channel, Chronoglide. Amplitude is the turning of the balance wheel measured in degrees. Beats per hour, and here lift angle on the standard 52 degrees. Here you see the lift angle and see what happens if I change the lift angle, see what happens to the amplitude. It is a bit wobbly, but if I adjust the lift angle a lot, you'll see eventually it go down to 60. To 40, to 20. So if you have the settings for your lift angle not correctly, you're not reading the right amplitude. But what is the lift angle for a particular movement? Most of the time you can find them in the specs, find them on the internet, but sometimes you don't. And I'm going to show you a really cool trick how to calibrate your timing machine and let you know visually what lift angle your movement is. So it is going to be very cool, trust me. Here we have the balance wheel and it is moving. You can see the spokes are a bit bendy, and that's the bit rate of our camera. You're watching now, this is the camera, and through my microscope you are watching the watch movement. So it's not registering the exact amplitude, but that's no problem. What is important is that the movement is clean, running well. So this is just for the final adjustment. So first things first, we are going to release the power on the mainspring. There we go. And the watch will stop running. And now the very cool trick. We know the amplitude. If it's 90 degrees, it goes from there. There we go. The amplitude, if it's 90 degrees, it goes from there to there. If it's 180 degrees, it goes from there to the other side. And that is a thing we are going to use. And I think if you're interested in mechanics and horology, you will enjoy this tip. Here we have a felt tip marker. And make sure you make a small mark on your balance wheel, but it's important that you can see 180 degrees. So if I make a small mark here, we have a visual on this side of the balance wheel. And I use a felt tip marker because with some isopropyl, alcohol, you can wipe it away and there will no trace whatsoever. So it's a real clean way of not leaving any marks afterwards. Simple. Here we have, do you see there? I just made a mark on the balance wheel. And we can easily wipe it away. What we are going to do is slowly wind the movement. There is going to be it self-starting, we know now, because the beat error was 0.0. But see what happens. I think it is really cool. Mark is over there, and we're going to wind it gently. You see, self-starting. And we see the mark moving there. A bit more. I am winding slightly the movement, just a few clicks. And now we see there. You see it? Just a tiny few clicks more, and now we see it there and there, because it's moving. You see the dots appearing there? It is one dot, but it's moving on both sides. When it's 180 degrees, the amplitude of the balance wheel, we made the mark there, but then we see only one mark on this side, and then one side and the other, then we know visually it is 180 degrees. There, it is a bit like a stroboscope effect, and see one there. See it? A tiny bit more force on the spring. And it's getting closer, 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 because it is going one side and the other. Maybe one more click. It will take some time. There, flickering, and there, flickering. So it is very close. We are getting very close to the 180 degree mark, because one way and the other, the single dot will have one position on the other side of the balance wheel. Well, the camera is having difficulties. You can see it on the spokes, the amount, the bitrate. But for me, visually, the mark is here, and that is exactly 180 degrees. Now we know the balance wheel has an amplitude of 180 degrees, visually. So now we are going to adapt, calibrate our timing machine to 180 degrees with the lift angle. And if we have the right lift angle, we will see 180 degrees. And then we have calibrated our machine and know what this particular lift angle is from this particular movement. Well, now you see the lift angle is very low, 36, We don't know what the lift angle will be from this particular movement. What we see here, the amplitude. We know visually that the amplitude at the moment is 180 degrees by the stroboscope tip. So if we increase the lift angle very slowly until we see 180 degrees there. We know visually this movement is doing 180. So we adjust the lift angle, we get 180 here. So we know from this Unitas 6497, the lift angle will be just around 44 degrees, and it is. So now we know we calibrated our timing machine. Now we wind it full. A very long power reserve this movement has, 52 hours. Fully wound, we know we have the correct lift angle, and now we have the coming up. It is going to increase probably a bit more. Here we have the proper reading. Well, this movement is for parts only, so it's not cleaned, it's not lubricated. There might be something wrong with it, but now we know that the lift angle, and it is going to be a bit more, I suspect. But hey, after cleaning maybe. But now you know the process of calibrating your timing machine to the correct lift angle. And even though the amplitude is really not high, we know we have the correct reading because the lift angle is visually compared to the 180 degrees with our stroboscope effect. I do hope that makes sense. I think it's an excellent and cool tip and inexpensive just to try at home. And now we have calibrated the machine to the visual of the movement. Well, my name is Kalle Slaap and I'm a watchmaker here in the Netherlands. Please leave your comments. It's really nice to hear what you think. If my way of explaining is good enough, and maybe you have ideas of future topics, and please give me a shout out and leave your comments. If you like this channel, please subscribe and do the bell icon, so every time we have some cool new video, you get a nice notification. Okay, thank you so much, and I hope to see you soon. See ya, bye bye.